Good morning. We're at -3, -4 this morning.
Calves all bedded up here.
It's looking like another clear, cold but clear day. Bucket doesn't crown back enough. Need to probably shift these brackets this way a bit and put a kind of back plate between the headstock and the bucket to change the angle of it. But we just make do because we don't use it that often. Job done. I've spilt a bit on the ground, so spilt it over the top. Bonker. Kev's just rocked up. He's putting the flatbed on, getting the silage bales that are on it. There goes Kev for the silage. The reason there's two different colours is because he ran out of wrap, the guy who was wrapping, so the next batch was a different colour. You hear some people speaking about the different colours. Dark absorbs a lot more heat and emits a lot more heat than a very light coloured. That's why your tinfoil is silver. It doesn't absorb or emit much heat. Hey boy!
Come on, pals. Why are you in? Chunky beasts, yeah.
These ones can go to the abattoir, these two now.
Ruff's a bit frozen. Well frozen. Oh, and my welly leaks. Oh, damn it. We're on to the first of the silage now. You can't really call it silage. Haylage. It's probably more like hay than even haylage, but anyway. They'll enjoy it.
They're straight in.
Although they like the ammonia straw, they definitely prefer... I'm going to call it silage. It's not really silage, but the silage. Kev's getting these all unloaded. I'm going to go and pick up the papers. I opened the door to this mutt. What are you doing in here? He has jumped his way through. You little bandit. None of that. The usual way I go to the papers, I can't go because the roads are mega. I've just looked online and apparently there's some cows loose at Brooks End Roundabout, which is a mile and a half that way. I don't know what's happened. I think probably a float has crashed and some cattle have managed to escape on the A9. The sun's kind of blocking the view, but if you can make out the lorries coming down that hill and all the traffic, that's usually empty. Right, put the flatbed on. I spoke about in the car park a while ago, I was going to put rails along the ends of the uprights that we've got in the car park. So I'm going to go and pick up a pallet of rails which we've got along at yard number 2, bring them back. I'll show you what I mean once we're up there. Kev's in the workshop there, he's grabbing all the bits and bobs we're needing. There's one post which is snapped, which is being replaced. I'm gonna go and grab these wooden battens, nab some screws off the tradesman, because I couldn't find some of our own the right size. It'll all go onto our bill eventually anyway. Just need to shift a few things out of the way. That's the battens in the back there, I'm needing that. An old auger bucket, which has not got the right pitch on the front of it. We'll probably start using that. Oh Jesus. Probably start using this. Once we get the shed sorted out, so I'll need to put some Sanderson brackets on it. I don't think I'm needing all of them. We're going to need to clear this whole bit because it's getting flattened soon enough. Strap down. Go on then, lad. We're off. So this is the top section of our car park, and we put these posts in just... when was that? 3, 4, 5, 6 months ago, whatever it was. We're going to put rails on the end, the T-bits, because these are the posts that get hit. These two end pieces, because they're in an angle, they're slightly longer, and they're too long. There's a few other bits we can do. We can do those two at that end. That corner is a wee bit to do there. But yeah, we can't do these two, because the rails are not flipping long enough. Dad must have replaced this one when I was away, but... he's left it sticking up way high, so we need to give this a thud down, which is annoying because it's really frosty just now, so
Don't know if it's going to budge.
And it seemed to go that way a wee bit.
This one's sitting a wee bit low compared to everything, so we're going to bring it up a fraction. Typical farmer saw this blunt as hell.
Anyway, we're deliberating whether it needs three posts or four rails. I think it needs four, but we'll try three to see how it looks. Three rails, four. It's like a professional did it. That one's done as well. Progress, we've run out of screws though. I'm gonna get some more and I'm gonna get a new saw. Instead of using a saw that's about 10 years old, rusty as hell. Two boxes of screws, two saws. There was a deal on, I had to buy two. I love a deal. Good old fashioned marketeering, two for a discount. They've got me, they made me buy two. Anyway, me and Kev will have one each. Jackpot. Should have just bought a battery powered DeWalt circular saw while I was there.
This one's sitting away off to that way. I've banged in about here in the base here to loosen it off. Kev's gonna give it a nudge with a forklift and hopefully it'll square up. Either that or it'll snap because the ground's really frozen solid. That'll do it. Still a wee bit off.
Hard now. A wee tiny, tiny.
That's it, bang on. These rails are just long enough. Is it just touching it? Yeah. Yeah. Alright, that'll be fine.
The big one, I just had it across here to see where you're.
Your way a bit. Right, surely no one hits this corner now. Surely, fingers crossed. As they do, ugh, what else can we do? We've got a tee here to do, a tee at that end, and there's one wee tee over there to do, and then that's all we can do with the lens we've got. You know what annoys me? People who drive in the grass and make a right mess. It's really annoying, we're having to chop a big chunk off because they're just not quite long enough to reach over here. Other than those bits Kev's just chopping off, that's that done. That bit's done, bit on each end. The only bits we can't do are the ones that are up there that are too long. We need to go and get lengths that are longer. I don't know how long you can buy lengths of wood in. I generally stick to metal, not wood. The chulips we planted a while back, a few months ago, they're kicking through. It was really mild in the back end, so that might have pushed them through, but they don't seem to have died anyway, they're still alive. I think there was 90 something thousand we planted there. So that'll be interesting to see how they go. Year two, experiment year two. Job done. They're relatively straight and square. Taking measurements off the side that we've not got wood long enough for. Gonna see if I can get my hands on some. Don't need much, just need 1, 8, 16, 20 lengths. I'm doing it. I'm going to be ruthless. They've been kicking about for years. How long will our new ones last? It's amazing. Refuse to spend £10 on a saw, but you spend six figures on a tractor. There's no point taking all this wood back along to yard two, because where it was, the shed's getting knocked down, so I'll need to find a space for it here. These are all offcuts, but they're quite long, so they're quite good. I'll save them. I'll leave them in the shed for 15 years. We'll get them in here. Kev put all this wood in here. This is what we pulled out of the wood a few weeks ago, before Christmas. Kev shoved it all in here so it can sit and dry off a bit, and we'll chop that next winter. Like a glove. I think this machine's getting picked up tomorrow, so we'll do three bales today, and then there's five left. We'll probably just blitz them tomorrow morning into the cows. That's plenty straw for them, but it's better than bundling them out by hand.
There she blows.
Kev's just covered me in flipping straw. Bandit.
Now that we've moved on to silage, it smells fantastic in here. The coos are happy as Larry. Anyway, just been speaking to a man from Bateman that make gates and barriers and shed stuff and cow stuff and livestock stuff. To do with a new shed. S&A, who are going to be building the shed, they're coming up next week. Talk to them about a few different concepts of designs and layouts and whatnot. We're getting there slowly but steadily. We are figuring out the shed situation. Anyway, cheers for watching. I'm just getting the key out of the forklift here. Please subscribe if you're not already. Like this video, and I'll see you tomorrow.